Well, it's going to be such a day of mixed emotions, isn't it? There's so much love for Neighbours, from Margot, Chris, Liam, Kylie and Jason. They're just some of the big-name Aussie celebrities who launched their careers on Ramsay Street. And the same can be said for our next guest.
Hi.
Hey, I'm Cassius.
Seriously? Like the calculator? Oh, wait, no, that's... Sorry.
What a nerd! It's an old Roman name.
Of course.
Yeah. Hey, I'm the gardener.
Well, you better watch your back with all this stuff. It's just we get a lot of back injuries at the hospital. I'm a doctor.
All right.
What an intro that was. Yeah, Takaya Honda landed his role on Neighbours back in 2016, playing the shy and socially awkward role of David Tanaka. The character made history for being involved in the very first same-sex wedding on Australian TV, which received worldwide attention. And Takaya joins us now. Good morning,
Yay!
Takaya.
This is awesome.
Good morning. Good morning. Look, I have to point out with that scene that just showed, I love that they picked it. There's two things. One, he's mowing a fake lawn, which is just bizarre. And two, I had actually shot Family Law for the first 3 days of that week in Brisbane, flown back and shot like 21 scenes between Thursday and Friday, and that was the last scene. So I was like delirious by the stage we were filming that, but it turned out really fun. So.
Is he available at all? I didn't even have a lawn.
I think he's filming something with Isabella Lucas at the moment. So.
There he goes. Yeah, speaking of your own role there, such a special TV moment it was. It was filmed right after same-sex marriage was legalised here in Australia. When you reflect on stuff like that, storylines and being involved in it, it must make you so proud.
I mean, what a privilege it is as an actor to be given the gift of representing a community in that way and being part of the first in Australian television. I'm so honoured, and I can't even put into words how proud I am to be a part of that. I don't know, Matt feels exactly the same way.
Yeah, we talk often about the crazy storylines, and we love those, but a lot of the storylines have broken new ground as well and have really championed social issues. Foster care was one of the issues that was touched on.
Yes, absolutely. And we had two brilliant young actors come on board during COVID as well. And so we were shooting, half the cast was outside and half the cast were inside and were kept there. So we're shooting outside these long hours in the freezing cold, and these two young actors, Ezra and Texas, absolutely showed us up and were able to then communicate this important storyline. And Deborah Lee Finesse obviously was there at the start to help kick the storyline off, directing it, yeah.
I wonder what's the feedback like when you're involved in something like this? Because it's something that people want to see and people can connect to. So I'd imagine you're bombarded with messages after being in storylines like this.
Yeah, and I mean, that's the best applause you can get in getting messages where you've changed someone's life or given them representation, as with the foster care storyline, that makes them feel seen. It's so important. Mental health, the biggest slogan that's around is like, you're not alone. Yeah. And representation on screen like this really makes people feel not alone. And I think that's one of the things, sadly, we'll be losing in a way with Neighbours.
Is that something that you kind of expect to be involved in? I mean, going back to when you first auditioned for the show, is this something that you kind of... What was that experience like?
Well, the audition experience was kind of crazy. Our casting director, Thea McLeod, she actually said it was the biggest audition or most intense audition experience she's had to do for the show. We had two callbacks. We had, I think the first round was like nine of us. Both, we're all having to learn both characters, David and Leo. And when you learn a scene and you have both characters, it's a really bizarre experience because you've got both lines in your head and switching between. It's just a bizarre... You don't do it anywhere else. It was really bizarre, but it was intense. But now I'm here, so that's
good. Did you watch the show growing up?
I did.
Yeah?
I did. And strangely enough, like, coming back to what you said before, did I see myself on or did I expect it? Like, I didn't... Growing up, it wasn't a show that I necessarily saw myself on because, you know, it's come a long way since then.
And they've been very open and honest about that too in terms of putting a multicultural face to Neighbours and how much has changed.
Absolutely. And I definitely wasn't the first in that case, but it's definitely a tribute to Jason Herbison, the producing team, for what they've done to increase that visibility.
You've done all your scenes, mostly. All your dialogue.
I've said all of my dialogue and... Exclusively, I can say my last line was, "That sounds dangerous." And that could mean anything, so...
How did you say it? "That sounds dangerous."
Well, no, but see, how I said it might give it away, so, you know, we've got to keep it.
How are you feeling about it all?
Look, I had the facade is good at the moment. Yeah. When we do the other one later on, it might be slightly less, and by the end of the day, I'm going to be a mess, to be honest. So it's a very strange and rare experience. Being part of the ending of a show after 37 years is... I don't think there's many shows that have ever done that. So
and it's not just any show. No. It's an iconic Australian soap opera that everyone knows.
Yeah, thanks for that.
Sorry.
No, yeah, absolutely. But do you know what I mean? Absolutely. Like,
the gravity of the situation is great. Yeah.
It means a lot to everyone out there, but I think for scale, it means even more to the people here and the people who have been here as long as the show. I mean, there's been the characters, of course, Steph and Dennis was here from the start, but there have been crew that haven't missed an episode working on it since the start, and that's huge. Their whole working lives have been on this show, which is kind of incredible.
Such a huge impact, yeah.
Thank you for chatting with us today.
Thank you for having me.
Hang in there. Awesome. Yeah. And we'll see you soon, because you're going to introduce us to the youngest cast member
yeah, I
of
think
the
so.
Show.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.